I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
See the superstars.
Hollywood to Hollywood.
Girl, you look good.
Yeah, they hollering, baby.
I keep modeling, baby.
ATL,
I put the spotlight on your city.
Carolina Finley.
I put the spotlight on your city.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Spotlight Over the City. I am your host, Stan Long, along with the lovely Terry T-Bomb Long. Give it up.
Woo! Yeah!
Thank you guys for tuning in. WLVS, thank you guys for being a part of the movement. Listen Vision family, we appreciate you guys. Everybody in the DMV, you already know we love you guys. We appreciate you for tuning in. The whole uptown, the whole south side, you already know. Northeast, north, was it southwest?
Southwest.
Largo, Rose. Shout out Cue the Fool, too, though. Largo. Who else?
Zachary Chambers. Largo. Yes. Largo in the building.
Yeah, the whole DMV, though, man. C Pleasant, Palmer Park. The whole everybody. Everybody at the sound of my voice. Atlanta. Hall Mills Network. If you tune in to Hall Mills Network, we are on Roku TV Live right this second. You can tune in to Hall Mills Network on Roku TV and go to Spotlight Over the City and check us out. So if you are tuned in right now, salute. We appreciate you guys for watching.
Yes.
What else we got? I got a screw.
Yeah, we got a lot of stuff, baby. We got you too far over?
I'm good.
All right, well, we do our little weekend recap real quick. Our weekend recap, we went to...
Wait. Sorry, not to interrupt you.
Okay.
Jeannie Jones in L.A. Salute. I cannot forget. That's the home team. Wow. So salute to you, Kitty of the City.
I miss her too. I miss you. Yeah, I miss you, Jeannie. Yes.
Yeah, so let's get to it.
Okay, we can recap. We want to congratulate Trey Chaney, who is family to us.
Trey
Chaney and Commodore Independent Filmworks for winning not one, not two, but three Black Continental Movie Awards for their documentary film, Undeniable, The Trey Chaney Story. We went and celebrated with them for a little while on Saturday. I got a picture of that. They won three awards.
They did.
Uh-huh. And it was a nice event. Three of them. So congrats to you, Trey Chaney and Anthony Commodore. Amazing documentary. We can't wait for everyone to see that.
That's a fly jacket. You see that jacket?
Yeah, I saw. You
see
look.
The young OG had the jacket.
You look kind of nice, honey. You did. Yeah. You look pretty good.
Everybody fly that night. Good.
Yes.
Good energy. Great night.
We actually Spotlight Over City had kind of a chill weekend, which we like sometimes because y'all know we be out in the community. We be everywhere. So this weekend was kind of chill. We did that, and then we had Father's Day. So happy belated Father's Day to all the dads and moms have to be dads. So happy belated Father's Day. What's going on this weekend, honey?
Well,
what's going on this weekend?
What's going on? Oh, wait a minute.
Wait
we got a
minute.
Book
what?
Signing.
Oh, that's on
the
Monday.
We got a book signing coming up Monday. OTI Ooh. Largo. Make sure you guys get out to OTI. Meet me Monday with Micheline Bowman. It's going to be a great time. Please come out and celebrate with us and have a great time. Great event. I'm going to be out signing books, shaking hands, talking trash. You already know I'm in the building. So
6 to 10 p.m., y'all,
out,
on
man.
Monday.
Black
please,
Melly,
please
the
come
we,
and support my husband's amazing book. You know, you all, those who know me, you know I'm not like a real reader of novels, but I read his book in like 2 days. It's a really great, amazing story, and it's inspiring, and he's mine. So, yeah.
Thank you. So I appreciate that, and I appreciate everybody who's already purchased the book. If you had one, come out and I'll sign your book. Just to come out and have a good time with us. Bring your book and I'll stroke the pen and we'll have a good time. So how about that? Monday, OTI Largo.
Well, I think it's some fun stuff going on in the city. But one thing in particular on Friday, tomorrow at the Anthem down on the D.C. Southwest Waterfront, T.I. is in the building tomorrow with Backyard Band. That's going to be kind of fun.
Oh, yeah.
T.I. and Backyard
so
at the Anthem.
There?
I mean, no, I didn't say we were there. We can go.
That'd be cool.
Yeah. But just wanted some of my friends and folks out there to know T.I. in town, y'all.
Shout out Tip.
Shout out Tip
for
Harris.
All the great stuff that you're doing in the communities, man. You have become a revolutionary.
Yes.
I like it. You are really leading the charge on a lot of things.
Yeah.
So we appreciate that.
Most definitely. Tip. Yeah. And before we get into the news, I did want to say I went to play rehearsal last night. So I want to remind you all that your girl T-Bomb is in her first stage play. I'm making my play debut.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Okay,
July 20th.
Proud of you. We like it.
Yes,
we like
July
it.
20th at the Lincoln Theater in D.C. Get your tickets. Any of you who support Spotlight Over City, if you're in the DMV area or you're going to be here that weekend, I expect to see your face in the building. July 20th, Confessions of a Side Chick, amazing, funny, what do they call it? Like a, it's a dramedy. So it's like a drama comedy. It's super funny, and I'm going to kill it. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah, we heard you killing it. I mean, killing it. So
I'm going to kill it. I can't wait.
But shout out to my my little girl, Sonny.
Oh, yeah.
I am so proud of that. Now, I'm the manager. I don't want y'all to get it confused. But I've been betting on this little girl for a long time. This little girl right here is going to shock the world. She's an extreme talent.
Yes.
Sing, dance, play the piano. She got a production company.
She can write music, compose it.
She composes her own music, mm-hmm. write her own. This little, 10 years old. He's talking
about my niece, by the way. My niece, so Sonny Neverson.
She's totally incredible. Shout out to her mom.
She's
going to
steal everybody's heart in this play. Sonny is one of the main characters, along with Lisa Renee, amazing. Dana is amazing.
Dana
Big
Dane.
G.
Shout out Dana Dane.
We've
Big
got some amazing
G.
talent.
Juan Glover.
Omar, the comedian. We've got some amazing talent in this play. You all did a great job, DC Black Broadway. Shout out to you all.
Yeah, shout out to LaVell and Vernon.
All right,
and
well,
Saladin.
Yeah, and Saladin. That's right, nephew.
Yeah,
Saladin.
My nephew.
That's right. So we're going to get to Spotlight News, and who is it sponsored by, honey?
You already know. Umbrella, Umbrella. Shout out my homeboy Wes over there, Umbrella Therapeutic Services.
Yes, Umbrella Therapeutic Services is DC's most reliable and trusted behavioral health organization. Umbrella provides community support, medical management, and therapy for individuals and groups, anybody for ages 5 to 100 or whatever. Start at age 5, and you can get these services if you're a DC resident. Call 1-888-793-4357 and request Umbrella Therapeutic Services.
Okay, and make sure you guys do that, because I'm telling you, a lot of times we have a stigma that we believe that something's got to be wrong, or something is definitely wrong if you go to see
and
seek
get mental
some
health.
Help. Mm-hmm. But I just want to say, if your car can get tuned up and all other things can get tuned up, so can your mind. Your mind is the most important thing, so you have to sometimes get you a check, and everybody deserves that.
That's right, baby. You ain't getting yours.
I do. I self-check.
Okay,
I do a lot of therapy, meditation, reading,
he
praying,
does.
This and that.
I come upstairs in the bedroom. Hey. This man got his headphones on or something. He is always filling himself with things like that. So that's one thing I admire about you.
I would. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah. I would tell anyone, you know, of course, I'm not the next man, and I don't claim to be better or worse or whatever. But I would say inner engineering is very important.
Yeah.
So I think that a lot of times we want to dress the part and look the part, to overlap some of the things that go on inside.
Yeah.
And so it looks good on paper, but we need to do some inner engineering. So
Umbrella
Services.
That's
Umbrella
right.
Therapeutic Services. Make sure you get that.
Congratulations to the Toronto Raptors for being the 2019
NBA
champions.
I give it up to them.
This is their first ever NBA championship. Give it up for them.
I ain't like it at first. I didn't.
I know you didn't. You
wanted
KD's
team.
No, I didn't.
I'm a KD. I rock with KD. That's the home team.
I get it.
But he has several rings. He didn't get a chance to participate. Gave his heart up on the court, which I like.
Yeah, because he suffered a ruptured Achilles, and then Klay Thompson suffered a torn ACL,
which is terrible. But yeah, so that's when I knew it was over, when I saw Klay hit the deck.
Yeah, so
I said, yeah. And then them dudes, it's a reason why they physical, man. Them
What's
young
the guy's
boys
name?
Are physical.
Kawhi Leonard, is that his name?
Kawhi Leonard.
He was the MVP. I mean,
man,
he
Kawhi
just
Leonard
really
been waiting his turn for years.
Yes.
He's out of San Antonio cooking and wasn't getting the credit because the old heads was out there stealing all the glory.
Yeah.
But this boy done got a franchise. This man has a franchise built around him.
Yeah.
And when I tell you he deserves a ring.
So congratulations, Toronto Raptors. Listen, y'all's president.
Drake, you
y'all
got your damn ring, Drake. Sit your ass down, man. That's enough of this.
Hey, Drake.
Next year, we're not doing that.
Okay. Y'all's president, I don't claim this person, but y'all's president said he is not apologizing to anyone for what happened with the Central Park Five men. And he put out that full page ad. He himself, our president, put out a full page ad back then saying 80,000 that they should get the death penalty. And now that they have been exonerated, he said.
So what did he say? Wait, let's listen to what he said.
Let's see what your friend's talking about.
We'll be right back.
Mr. President, will you apologize to Central Park 5? They've been exonerated. There have been videos and movies shown about the case, and you came out with a full-page ad saying that they should die, that they should have the death penalty.
Why do you bring that question up now? It's an interesting time to bring it up. You have people on both sides of that. They admitted their guilt. If you look at Linda Fairstein and if you look at some of the prosecutors, they think that the city should never have settled that case. So we'll leave it at that.
Welcome back to Spotlight of the City. So, hey, you guys, you make the call. I've been knew he was crazy. This dude right here
he
different.
He said, no, I ain't apologizing. He said, they.
I mean, what'd you expect?
Yeah, that's what I expect from you, sir, whatever your name is. Anyway, he's not getting more airtime. So, moving on. I don't know how to pronounce his name. How you pronounce his name, baby? Digimon Hounsou?
Well,
remember he was married to Kamora Lee Simmons? Remember?
About 15
minutes. And he played in... DZ, what he played in?
Him.
That's their son, Kenzo, right?
He actually played in a few.
Kamora Lee
Russell. In my mind, that's Seal. In my mind.
That's not Seal.
That's not Seal?
How you say his name, y'all?
In my mind, that's Seal.
Dishmon
something. That's Seal's little brother.
Huh?
Yeah, Blood Diamond.
That's what it was. He was in Blood Diamond. Well, listen.
Thank you.
He married Kamora Lee Russell or whatever. They were, would have had a committed relationship for many years. And they had a son together, Kenzo, who is now 10 years old. And he was asked, not Kenzo, but the father, the actor, Kamora Lee's ex.
Blood Diamond dude, yeah.
He has not been allowed to see Kenzo or contact his son. And he said he doesn't know the last time that he can remember being able to contact or see his son. So we want to know, I need to scoop on, why is Kamora Lee Simmons keeping Kenzo from his daddy? She shouted out Russell Simmons on Father's Day, and her current husband, whose his name is Wolf. She married this billionaire white man now.
His name Wolf?
Wolf something. Okay. Yeah, and she shouted them out for Father's Day, but Kenzo's daddy is Digimon Hounsou, and he hasn't seen his child, and he don't even remember the last time he seen him. And that's just sad
not
to
cool,
me. I don't like
not
that.
Not cool. You already know how I feel about
so
that.
So he didn't have a great Father's Day, and I just don't like stuff like that.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that, Seal.
But we're going to get the scoop and let y'all know why.
You heard me call him Seal.
Yeah, he's not Seal,
that's
baby.
That's Seal, little brother.
Seal is used to be married to Heidi Klum.
Okay, it's Seal's cousin. Damn, okay. Terry. They related. They got to be.
They related.
In my mind. Yes.
Okay, listen, y'all. The feds done went up there to the docks in Philly and seized an estimated $1 billion worth of cocaine, y'all. 16.5 tons from a ship in Philly was seized this week.
Wow.
And they said this is one of the largest
I'm
drug busts.
I'm flashbacks in my mind.
Listen, one of
I'm up. Flashing back a little bit. I'm getting
you
hot.
Got a flashback?
Yeah, it's 88 in
Babe,
my mind right now.
You
it's
going
88.
Back to the 80s?
Whoo! Lord help
oh,
me.
Oh, thank God my
yes,
husband is transformed.
I'm being reformed.
Thank
when
you.
I saw that,
thank God for
when
your
I first
transformation.
Saw it, my body went in the shock. I was just like, what?
Yes,
like,
baby.
Wait. I started counting it up. I said, okay, for about
16.
It was probably like 12,000 a brick. And it was how many of them bricks? I was like, whoo.
Oh,
in my mind,
goodness.
I was like, I could have sold them for $15,000.
Don't listen to my husband.
Hey,
he's going back to the days
really
in the 80s.
In my mind, but I'm back.
16.5
yes.
tons. Like, what does that mean in cocaine term? I don't know what that is.
Well,
what does that mean?
How many? Let me see.
16.5 tons,
I would
a
say,
billion? How many bricks?
I wouldn't say $1 billion. Street value is different. They done broke it down to dimes and sold it to crackheads and this and that. It's probably about $200 million worth of cocaine.
Well, it was one of the largest drug busts in U.S. history, and they were saying that the ship was previously docked in the Bahamas, Panama, and Peru, and
well,
Colombia.
Okay, somebody snitched, because I heard them say an informant, they got
oh,
tipped off.
Oh, they
so
got
in
tipped.
In my mind,
somebody
now,
snitched.
How much money did you get to turn all this cocaine? How much money did
but
you
look,
get?
One of the celebrities on, one of the NFL players, I forgot who it was, something Crockett, he said, give up 16.5 tons to get 35 to 45 tons across. It's chess, not checkers. The
and
marathon
that's a fact.
Continues.
I didn't want to get into all
I
of that.
I was like, what?
But I'm going to just be honest with you. So allegedly, I don't know how the game really played.
He said he owned it. So allegedly.
In my mind, this is just TV talk, but you will let a few shipments get trapped off because – I don't know that that's the particular one that they would have preferred to get trapped off. But you know that out of 10 boatloads, 2 boatloads going to definitely be snatched up. But that's a part of the game, and they play that game. So he's
wow.
right. If 100 tons go one way, 300 go another way, 150
wow.
go
wow.
another way.
Yeah,
and so
well,
at the end of the day, our government allegedly is aware
yeah.
of these situations or it wouldn't be there.
Estimated $1 billion worth. So anyway. Moving on to my husband's favorite segment of the show. You want to tell them what your favorite segment is?
Okay, I will. Okay, so Spotlight Shining Star is a segment in Spotlight that we Spotlight people who do amazing things for the community, in the community, around the community. You could be rich, poor, famous, not known. Whoever you are, we like to tell good news on Spotlight Over the City. So this is my favorite segment.
And yes,
so
it is.
Let's rock.
Who's this week's Spotlight Shining
Who's
Star?
Who's this week's Spotlight
happens
Shining
to
Star?
Be from my county, Prince George's County, Maryland.
The best county.
Yes, the best county.
The flyest county.
The flyest county. The Black Wall Street County.
Black Wall Street County.
Yes,
PG
you all
county.
Know PG County has the most wealthiest blacks in the United States.
Be clear.
Whoop, whoop. Let's be clear.
Bunch of business owners, that's bunch
right.
of go-getters.
That's
it's
right.
Black Wall Street all the time,
that's
every
right.
time.
Prince
PG
George's
County,
County
be clear.
Maryland. Yes, well, the Spotlight Shining Star this week is Dr. Monica Goldson, who has been named as the new CEO of Prince George's County Public Schools, y'all.
That's right. That's
yes.
right. That's right. That's
yes.
right.
Yes, I'm
big
loving.
Deal. She's from PG County.
She's, yes.
With the school. Here, her children are in school here. This is somebody who knows the system.
She's been in the PG County public school system for 40 years. So like Stan said, she went to PG Public County Schools. She put her kids through PG Public County Schools. And she's been working in the county as, you know, different positions throughout her legacy in the county school system. She's been a principal. She's been a teacher. She's been all through the county school system. So what better person would be suited for this job than her. I'm so happy. Black girl magic, y'all.
Let's give
Black
it up.
Girl
One more
magic.
Time. Give
I
it
love
up.
It.
Give it up.
Yes.
PG County, we do
yes.
it. We do it. We
That's
do it.
That's right. We do it.
And so we got to get out to L.A. real
yeah,
quick.
Yeah, we got, oh, y'all, we got a great interview coming up from an actor and an author out in L.A. His name is Rodney Damon Collins, right? I got it right. Rodney Damon Collins is coming right up after this quick commercial break, and you all going to learn all about some of the great things that he's been doing and his book as well. So coming up right after this commercial break.
We'll be right back. Spotlight right back. Over the City.
Spotlight over the city.
You ready to rock, rock, y'all? To the beat, y'all. Keep going, and you don't stop.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
Welcome to Spotlight Over the City, and I'm here with the one and only, the big homie of all big homies, Mr. James Prince himself. What's going on, big homie?
Oh, yeah. What's up, DC?
I put the spotlight on your city.
The moral voice of the movie. I'm playing a old school cat that's in a wheelchair.
I'm going to get them first, so that's how that's going to work.
Yeah.
You got warrants in D.C.?
I got warrants all over the place. I got warrants in 6 countries.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
Welcome back to Spotlight Over the City. What's going on, bro?
Hey, hey, what's up?
Hey, man, good to have you. Good to have you aboard.
Yeah.
Can you see us?
Yes, I can. It's good to be here. Thanks for having a brother.
Man, we appreciate it.
Oh, we appreciate it. You know, I went to high school with one of your friends out there, Tish.
Oh, really?
Yes, she and I went to high school together, and I said, you know what? Y'all are doing some great things out there in L.A. Like, we need to get some of y'all on this show, and she said, Rodney is the one. He is doing some of the most fun, amazing things out there. There was some sort of TV, not a TV show. I think it was something about the single life or something like that you all were doing.
Yes.
I was like, that looked like it was a lot of fun. So I just want you to, you know, give everyone, our viewers and our listeners all over. I mean, we're based in the DMV, but as you know, we are spotlight over every city. So people
every
are watching
city.
From all over. And we just wanted them to know a little bit more about you and about some of the fun things you've worked on, the fun people you've worked with, and your book.
Okay.
And congratulations on being an author.
Yes.
Me as well. And I know that's a tough one.
Yes.
So it's not easy to do. A lot of commitment.
Thank you. I salute you because I read about your book. I read about your book and your story, too. So I definitely know you understand the struggle.
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Yeah.
So congrats on that.
Give us a rundown about who you are and some of, like I said, some of the great things that you have done.
Oh, wow. I'll start off, man. It's like, let me start off first by just saying I've been married for 23 years.
Ooh,
I'm a faithful black man. Yeah,
hey, man.
Yes, you. You
incredible
got
wife.
You keeping hope alive. I appreciate that.
That's right. That's right. My wife, we met in college, so I'm going to celebrate that first and foremost, that I've had a sister by my side for 23 years, 25 total, and that's we're walking together this whole journey. She's a teacher. And we have two incredible young adults now, 20 and 21-year-old son and daughter. And so let me. I just wanted to start with my family because they got my back. They have been supporting me through this whole deal. I wanted to start with that. I went to Bowling Green State University. After that, I worked in corporate America for several years, and I did nonprofit work. I traveled over to Africa to help build a school in Monrovia, Liberia, with my wife and with several people from a church in Cleveland, Ohio. That's where I moved out here from Cleveland, Ohio.
Wow.
And yeah, it's been pretty cool. Then I actually had the opportunity to plant a church in the Cleveland area. So I have experience. I'm a former minister. I have a master's
divinity. I like it.
So I've studied seminary as well. And then after that, took some time working in the private sector. And then we ventured out to move to Los Angeles, California.
Woo-hoo. That's what's up.
Yeah, this big is what we right? always big wanted adjustment. To do. Yeah. I love it. I love living here.
That's what's up.
It's a crazy place. It's a crazy place, but it's a beautiful place. Since we moved out here, I've had the opportunity to become a series regular on an Amazon television show, which is entitled Chosen Kin Origins. It's a superhero show written by a young black male named Nico Sparks.
I love it.
This show is possibly in consideration for an Emmy in the short form category on Amazon. So that was, and my character is Dr. Watson.
Okay,
so Dr. Watson.
Dr. Watson.
That's so what's up.
I liken it to David Duchovny from The X-Files and Samuel L. Jackson, Nick Fury, kind of meshing those characters. That's what my character is like.
That's
a little
up.
Bit of that.
I love it.
Gotcha.
Wow. That is sounds so super cool and fun. You have done some fun stuff. So who do you consider as mentors in the entertainment industry?
Oh, man. I start first and foremost with the incredible Bill Cobbs. Bill Cobbs has been in the game for 40 plus years, and he's from Cleveland. And he pulled me under his wing as soon as I moved here. And Bill has really provided a lot of mentorship and guidance. I can go over his house anytime. He holds me in check, holds my feet to the fire.
Yeah.
Then we also have Elise Neal. Actress Elise Neal is one of my mentors. She's become a very good friend of my family, and she's like rooting for me. So it's really cool to have somebody like her who's like really, she's still active in the game, but she's like here trying to pull me up too.
Yes. And then, she played in Set It Off, right? And many other things.
She's played in a number of
movies. I know,
movies.
But I remember her most for her role in Set It Off. I like her a lot.
And then she'll tell you she's part of the Marvel Universe because she was in the Logan film.
Okay.
That's her and her husband
that's
get
big.
Killed. But
that's huge. Yeah, that's huge.
That is huge. Wow.
And so she'll tell you she's now part of the Marvel Universe.
Wow.
And then James Pickens, who is Dr. Weber on Grey's Anatomy, is one of my mentors as well.
Ah, you've picked some good ones.
Yeah, great
no
ones.
Wonder you're on such a great path. Yeah, you've got some great mentors.
I feel very blessed.
Yeah.
They hold my feet to the fire, though. They hold my feet to the fire.
So what types of things are you looking forward to working on in the future? I mean, you know, do you have any things that you're working on coming up? What types of things are you looking forward to doing, you know, in the near future? And tell us a little bit about your book.
Okay. Well, in the near future, let me celebrate that we just finished a play entitled Neighbors Out Here. It was written by a sister named Cassandra Sanders, directed by actor John Tolles Bay, featuring Daryl Allen Reed, another actor who's been around a long time. This play garnered a lot of support. We did it twice, two weekends, four shows in 3 days in the past month. And the NAACP actually came to our last showing as they are looking at it and considering it for a possible Image Award. And I had to celebrate that. I wrote my Image Award acceptance speech 2 years ago. It's in my journal.
I like that.
Wow.
2 years ago.
So you pulled that thing right onto it in existence.
There you go.
Right on down. Pull it on down.
I had to share that.
Yes.
And then there's some upcoming projects. I had to sign an NDA, but there's a possible Netflix show that is in the works. It's in pre-production right now that I'm being considered for the lead for. So this will be, it could be life changing a little bit, you know, a little nicer.
Yes.
Especially out in Los Angeles.
So we're going to touch and agree.
You can use that consistent money out here.
There right. You go. We're going to touch and agree and say you already have that role.
That's right.
We're going to say yes. That's already wrapped up.
That's right.
Yeah. Big things going on for you. I appreciate you for your humbleness too, though. Like, you have a lot of things going on. A lot of people got a lot less than you going on, but you wouldn't think so. So we appreciate the humility, you know what I mean?
So let's get to this book, Shattered. What do you want people to walk away with after reading your book? It's called Shattered. You all see this?
First of all, where can they find your book? Make sure we can get you found first. Where can they find your book?
You can find this book on Amazon.com through Kindle, paperback. And I'm actually in talks with a few additional publishers on putting it into the stores. And I'm working on, you know, God willing, being able to do a book tour sometime this year after talking with a publisher today. So
yes,
that's it.
I would love to. The book is entitled Shattered, A Journey Through the Pieces. And what I did is I took different parts of my life and the principles that I've learned to help me get to this point in my life. And I share it with people. I share, I'm real. I share a bout that I had with mental illness. And I'm not afraid to say that.
Yeah.
I used to be afraid to say that, you know, especially, you know, as a man, as a black man, I'm like, that's the last thing I wanted to do is tell somebody, oh man, I had a real strong bout of depression where I nearly took my own life. And I'm not afraid to share. I'm not afraid to say that now. I'm free. Free to say that because
so happy
I want somebody
that.
To know about it. I experienced a major fall in my life. And at one point it just felt like there was no hope, but there was things that helped me stay focused. First of all, God. Then I had my wife and my son and daughter. I had reasons to live. I have reasons to live and fight every single day.
Yes.
So this book, I share about my dreams. I share about the broken dreams, but I also share that through those broken dreams, it's come together to form an incredible, beautiful portrait that is my life today.
Man, beautiful
Isn't
stuff.
That something?
The one thing, first of all, Umbrella is one of our major sponsors in this therapeutic services, and what they do is handle mental health. So we just was talking about that. So I'm really happy to hear you have the guts. It takes courage to talk about what people would consider your shortcomings, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
But we all kind of sort of have some type of things that we haven't dealt with in our past that we maybe should. And so congratulations to you for even being bold and coming out and saying, this is my situation in the past and I've overcome it. So a lot of people are there now. They're still right there in the trenches right now today.
Yeah.
So that's very important to be transparent.
I'm excited too. I'm gonna make sure that we pick up a copy of your book as well because it's an amazing story. And I want all the viewers and listeners. Liz, can you put the book up one more time?
Yeah, and definitely make sure you stay locked and loaded with us. So we'll
Shattered.
Support your whole journey as far as you go. You get big, bring us with you.
That's right. Spotlight over the city.
We doing this.
Or bigger.
We're doing this.
That's right. We are doing it. Touch and agree.
Yeah, it's done. And so we appreciate
Bam.
You, man. Yes. And again, salute to you for your courage and everything that it takes to write a book, gutting it out and going through the procedure. A lot of people will tell you, I'm going to write a book. I started to write a book. I'm, you know, all of that kind of stuff. But the dedication. And so you're dedicated and have other things, including family going on, and you're still pressing. And so I love the fact that you big up your family as well first.
Before
you gave
he
the
even
order
got
of the day.
Started. That's
the order
right.
of the day. So I like it.
Yes.
Yeah. Salute. So we appreciate you so much for being a part of Spotlight Over the City. You know, it's not even, what is it, four? It's like 4 something in the afternoon there.
And, about 4:20.
Yeah.
So we truly appreciate your time. And like Stan said, we consider you as part of the Spotlight family once you come on our show. So please keep us in the loop on anything you've got coming up. If you want us to share with our viewers, let us know.
For sure.
Yep.
I will definitely keep you updated and... Can I just add one more thing?
Sure.
I know I'm running out of time.
No, you're good. Sure. Do your thing.
If you want to connect with me, follow me on Instagram. That's where I'm at most of the time. Rodney Damon Collins. Very easy to find.
All one word, all together.
And also, I'm very passionate about combating suicide. I actually am a speaker for a suicide prevention organization out here because they said since 1999, suicide has risen in the United States 33%.
Wow.
So it's become, people are living and feeling like there is no hope.
Yeah.
I want to help people have hope, man. So your show is what's giving me hope. It's giving other people hope. So you all keep spreading the word. I love seeing this husband and wife team. Y'all killing it.
Oh, man, thank we you appreciate so you. Much.
God is good, man. That's a blessing. We love to hear that. Yeah. And we give it up to God for
Check
that.
Check out season one 2018 shows on Roku TV out there, y'all in LA. If you have Roku
make sure
TV,
you check
us out.
On Roku too.
Yeah.
But we definitely appreciate that. That's a big deal for us. We appreciate it.
Yep. So and stay so, in touch.
Yeah, make sure you keep us locked and loaded, man. Don't leave us.
Will do. You all take care.
Thank
all
right,
congrats
you so much.
Again. Congrats.
All right. Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye.
That was
man,
wonderful.
Great interview.
Yes.
Yeah,
great energy. Give it up.
Great guest.
Yes.
Great guest.
So
great
Rodney
guest.
Damon Collins, y'all, all the way from LA. We appreciate all of our guests. We appreciate that. And
definitely, definitely. I just love to hear the good energy that we bring forth in other people. They bring it to us, we bring it to them. And it becomes a family thing, and that's what's good about Spotlight Over the City. And I love that God has given me a platform to do such a thing. That young man is very humble. He has a lot of things going on. Some things he probably didn't even mention that he did not bring up. So I really appreciate that kind of stuff.
Yes,
I like those kind of
me
people.
Me too.
So my kind of guy.
Yeah, before we get to this next commercial break, I did want to let you all know in advance to look forward to our show next week. Next week, we're going to not be in here. We're going to be broadcasting live from the Nelson Manor.
The Nelson Manor.
I
want to
show
exciting.
You all what you're going to see next week when we're going to be broadcasting live from Nelson Manor. DZ, can you run that video real quick?
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
So next Thursday, you all, Nelson Manor, it's going to be a 2-hour show. The live broadcast will still be from 7 to 8. So you'll still be able to log into www.spotlightoverthecity.com like you normally do. But we will be broadcasting live from the Nelson Manor.
The Nelson Manor.
Grown and sexy next week, y'all.
It's going to be exciting.
Something
tell
really
about
different.
Some of the panelists. What about our panelists?
Oh, yeah. We've got the Duncans. Do you all remember the couple? We had them on for Valentine's Day show, but
amazing couple.
Yes, they were all over the news. They went viral because they did their wedding all on camera, and they're going to be joining us next Thursday. The Nelsons. So they're hosting, but they're also going to join the panel. The Nelsons, Taurus and Yolanda Nelson, as well as Stan and myself. And we've got Tara Gates Anderson joining us and Bashay Williams, who is a relationship expert. He's got a book out about relationships. So it's going to be a really, really great show.
It's going to be amazing.
We want to make sure we're going to be doing a contest online starting tomorrow through next week for 10 of you all, 10 of our viewers, listeners, followers to come and join us in the live studio audience. So pay attention to our contest that's going to be coming up on Facebook and Instagram. So we're going to be giving away 10 tickets so you all can join us at the Nelson Manor next week. Yay! I'm
Let's see what's
excited.
Going on Facebook real quick. What's Shout out, Jeff. What's going on, Big Jeff? Southside.
What you got on there, baby?
I got a bunch of people. I ain't got my glasses on. I'm trying to...
You got Cousin Isis on there. You got
Isis, what's going on? Tawana, Lisa, Brian Ferguson. What's happening? Big Jeff, Southside. Isis, hey, baby. Cuzzo, I see you.
Yes.
Everybody on Facebook, we appreciate you guys for being locked and loaded with us. We love it.
Yeah, we have Facebook too.
Yeah, we're on Facebook Live right now.
Share it. Hey, if you all are watching us right now on Facebook Live instead
make sure
of
you share the show.
Share the show, y'all. Listen, we gotta take a quick commercial break because we got two more. You gonna sing?
I thought about
okay,
it.
Okay, do it
before the show.
You wanna do it?
Yeah, before it's over.
Before it's over.
Let's go to a commercial. Let's do the book trailer real quick. Let's talk about it real quick.
Okay. All right.
We'll be right back. Spotlight.
In 1990, Washington, D.C. saw more than 470 homicides, earning it the label Murder Capital of the U.S.
Shit, there you go right there. Hey, listen, when y'all pull over to the side, I'm gonna go in here and rush this dude. When y'all see me rushing, y'all rush in. About 30 seconds, give me about 30 seconds and rush the door. He ain't gonna know what hit him.
What's up with you, man?
How you feel, dude?
Good, man.
What's going on with you, man?
Man, I gotta tell you about this meeting, my nigga.
Oh, yeah, how that go?
I don't know yet. I'm trying to see. I went and talked with Diamonds the other day, man. I don't know, man. It's been a little funny.
Damn,
I can't really say.
Uh-huh.
But I got a funny feeling that these dudes are feeling at me, son.
So, you already know what it is. Wait for Black to get in there. Give us the signal. Run up in the junk. Snatch this nigga up. Get this bread. Spaz out.
Welcome back to Spotlight Over the City, you guys. Make sure you guys go out and support my book. I will be at OTI this Monday. Meet me Monday with Micheline Bowman. We're going to have a great time. Make sure you guys come out and support. If you already have a book, just come out and kick it with me and bring your book and let me sign your book and talk a little trash to you. So we're going to have a great time. I just wanted to say that. And if you don't have a copy and you don't want to wait, then you can always go on Amazon.com and grab your copy of BlackbirdMelly.com.
Yes. BlackbirdMelly. Get my husband's book, y'all.
Yes. And it's watch that film. We got something cooking. This we're going to turn that thing into a movie. And so that's what I'm working on as we speak.
Yeah. All right. Well, who do we have here? We can't just skip over the fact that we came
we
back from a
properly
commercial with this beauty
plus
sitting
one,
in between us.
Right?
Our plus one. Who do we have here, baby? We got
the one and only. No, first let me let you introduce
Dynamic
Girl Power.
Public Relations. The face behind it, Miss Allie, is in the building.
Yeah, let's give it up one time. Yes.
Thank you for having me, guys. I appreciate being here.
Oh,
thank
no.
You
family.
You already know.
Thank you.
She's family, y'all. Thank She's you. Been here before, and we love Allie, and we treat you as family. So anytime Allie calls us and say, hey, you know, we need this or her clients, then just consider it done.
And so we appreciate that, too, though. And this is one of the hardest working women in the industry. This woman stays somewhere doing something for somebody.
Yes,
and
yes.
So we appreciate that.
Well, she is here today to represent one of her clients because they're putting on an amazing Broadway musical, right?
Yes, Hustle the Musical.
You all seen it on our page this week, yep. So you got a glimpse of it. But Allie's going to tell us more about it. I'm going to tell you how you can see this Broadway musical and everything else great we need to know about it. Let's go do it, Allie.
Definitely. So Hustle the Musical debuts in Washington, D.C. at the Arc on July 2nd and 3rd.
Allie, let me get your mic up a little bit. Can you turn the mic up just a tad bit, sir?
Can you hear me?
Just
can
a little
me?
Bit. Check. Can you hear? I'm good. How about her?
Go.
You good now?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so Nikki Fortune's Hustle the Musical will debut in Washington, D.C. on July 2nd and 3rd at the Arc on 1901 Mississippi Avenue, Southeast at 7 p.m. This musical, when I watched it in Philly on Mother's Day, phenomenal production. I had no expectations, but after watching it, I was like, when is this gonna hit Broadway?
Wow. Because
that's how phenomenal it was, from the writing to the singing to the songs. It was captivating.
Wow.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to it.
We are. I was captivated, like with some of the little clips you sent. I was just like, oh, they really.
But here's the thing. So Nikki Fortune wrote Hustle the novel, okay? And it was published about a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then less than a year later, it's been adapted into a musical.
How about that? How about that, Nikki Fortune?
Exactly.
Yeah,
more Black Girl Magic.
I like
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
I like it.
So, again, this is a production you don't want to miss. Action-packed, great music, great acting.
So can't July 2nd and 3rd?
2nd and 3rd, yes.
You know, July 3rd, what is that day, baby?
That's my wife's birthday.
Oh.
Birthdays.
Okay.
Cancer Nation.
Yes.
Yeah,
July
cancer.
3rd.
Yes.
So, and at the Arc, that's where I had play rehearsal. So, that's a very nice facility, y'all.
Definitely.
I've been to
yes.
plays there before. How do they get tickets?
You can log on to www.hustlethemusical.com or Hustle the Musical on Instagram.
Y'all got that? Hustle yes. the Musical.
One more time.
www.hustlethemusical.com or Hustle the Musical on Instagram.
Well, since they didn't come to perform the song, Allie, are you prepared to do it yourself?
You going
to
sing? You going to bust out one time?
No, I don't sing. I do many things, but singing is not one of them.
I figured you were going to go ahead and bust it down one time.
Singing is not one of them. But again, the singing, the acting, this production definitely is headed to Broadway very, very shortly.
Love it.
Yay. Yes. We are fans, yes. So Nikki, you're on your way, girl, and we are fans. So if Spotlight Over the City can do anything to help you all get that thing
Thank
out
you.
There,
Thank you.
Just let us know.
Thank you so much.
We yeah, so make sure you guys Thank get you. Those tickets and support. Yes. Please go out and support. Make sure you get your tickets.
Yes, yes, yes. I think July 1st, we might can go to that one then, babe. No, July
2nd. No, it's the 2nd and 3rd, right?
2nd
and 3rd.
Yes, we sure, yeah. We'd love to have Spotlight in the City there, too.
You would?
Of course.
Well, you
of
already
course.
Know.
Of course.
Well,
put us in the building.
Put us in there.
Of course, you're there.
Allie, you got the plug. You can get us
out. I got the plug. Okay.
Okay. I forgot you are the plug.
Allie is the plug. Yeah, you better know it.
You better already know.
That's
so
right.
Thank I remember you. A long time. I was in Atlanta. This is a funny story. You don't even know. You have a friend that is a mutual friend of ours, mm-hmm. right? And I was in Atlanta, and I was trying to get back home and talking about doing some stuff around in the city. Mm-hmm. And she said, I got to get you with my girlfriend, Allie. She the bomb. She'll get you
wow.
out there, right?
Are you serious?
And this was years ago. This was a while ago, wow. yeah. And I was like, look wow. So now, look. So now we're friends. And I don't know why I never thought to tell you that. But I was when I first met you, I wanted to say, I remember hearing about you a long time ago. So you've been doing it for a minute.
Well, here's the thing. It's clients like Nikki Fortune and Eli.
Mm.
Clients
yeah, shout
like
out
that.
Eli.
Who, yes, he's dope. Yeah. But clients like that who really keep me motivated to do what I do, and they keep my reputation in the industry consistent.
Yeah.
So, yeah. again, well, shout out to Nikki Fortune. Thank you so much for retaining me and believing in dynamic public relations. We're here representing you on your behalf.
And you are in good hands.
You are in great hands, see. Nikki. Yes,
and
you.
Eli,
yes.
Eli, that little fella, I remember he came on here. I told him, I said, young man, you are going to be phenomenal. You
he
have
has
it.
Some. He has some things cooking.
We gotta get
so.
Eli
I saw
back.
That Michael Jackson. He did a Michael Jackson thing in New York, a piece.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw it. I was like, wow. Look
yeah,
at
we
him.
Gotta get Eli back then.
Definitely.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. So make sure you get him back on here as soon as you can. We need.
Is there a way that people can follow Hustle the Musical just so they can keep updated on it?
Definitely. So Hustle the Musical on Instagram. Just one word: Hustle the Musical on Instagram.
Okay.
You can also go to Hustle the Musical on Facebook as well as directly to their website. HustleTheMusical.com.
Okay.
Again, July 2nd and 3rd at the Arc on Mississippi Avenue, 7 p.m. Tickets are only $25.
Come on, y'all.
Okay?
So come on now.
Show up
so
and show
catch
out.
It now while you can before it hits Broadway
yeah.
and tickets are triple the price.
That's
so
right.
See,
okay?
That ain't number two drinks.
That's right.
That's it.
That's
two
right.
Two drinks, you in the door.
$25, July 2nd, 3rd at the Arc over there off of
7
Mississippi
p.m.
Avenue.
Yep.
It's a great facility, you all. I've been yep. there, so I want to see you there, okay? See
yes.
you in the building.
All
Thanks
right. Thanks again, Allie. We appreciate
Thank
you
Thank you so much, Allie.
Thank you for having me.
Your cute
see
self.
You there.
Thank
we'll
you.
Be right back after this commercial,
you.
Spotlight
Yay.
Over the City.
Spotlight Over City. All right.
Thank you, guys.
Yay.
I appreciate you. Thank you. So what
no.
do you do for your birthday?
I don't know.
Take us to
a
commercial.
We're long overdue for some drugs. Let me get the hell out of here. But we're long overdue.
He still got
his life. Have a good time. Just want to have a good time. Just want to have a good time.
Sitting in my room with words all over the walls. Quotes of inspiration for any time that I fall in. Bible verses just to keep the hope up, cause it's hard to hold up your life on your own shoulders. And looking up, I got 5 years to plan for. And honestly, adversity I did not plan for. But never really get to choose the life you live. So I'm looking up, trying to see where my sunshine is. So I say, come shine your light on my flowers, I need. Swear it's been raining for hours, I need the beauty without pain. So sunshine can't have flowers without rain, oh. So it rains more, it pours down, and as the shining sun, please shine down on me. Cause that means there ain't no stopping. That means the pain will stop. And I need this pain to stop. But I need it to rain a lot. But that means the rain won't stop. And I need
your hand up to say no more rain. Say no more rain. No more rain.
Keep the dream alive. They cutting me at six a week, cause that's an extra life. Picking up extra shifts, cause I need some extra lives. Been working so much, man, it feels like I ain't got no life. And all my friends just going out and traveling. I'm at the point where I don't even know what's happening. Yeah, they snapping me, but I ain't really snapping them. They posted in 2 months, they asking if I'm still rapping. And it just rains more, it pours down. Oh, Mr. Shining Sun, please shine down on me. Cause that means the rain will stop. And that means the pain will stop. And I need this pain to stop. But I need it to rain a lot. It's now I've realized no pain, no gain. Yeah, you know the same, but it's not the same as living it day to day. I've seen this rain for days and days. It's rained 4 days to date. When I stop getting mad when things ain't go my way, I left it in God's hands in the time I pray. What do you know? Some flowers grew, and they were so beautiful. See, they were so beautiful. The flowers picked up down. You can't have flowers without rain. Can't have flowers without rain. No flowers without rain. Oh. Can't have flowers without rain. You can't have flowers without rain. So there's no beauty without pain. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Spotlight Over the City. And as you can see, we have another plus one in the building. We have all the way from New York City by way of the DMV because he is from this area. But we have Zachary Chambers in the building. Give it up, y'all. Woo!
Thank you so much for having me. Hello.
How are you? You traveled down to New York City from New York City.
I did. I actually got on the bus at 1 p.m. today.
So, yay. How about that?
Yeah, you know, you got to do what you got to do.
You got to do what you got to do. Well, we're very appreciative for you stopping by Spotlight Over the City. Obviously, if you're here, we recognize some talent because otherwise, you know, you wouldn't even be here. We like to spotlight all talented people that we see. We love to do that, and that's just one of the things we pride ourselves on. We see people are talented out there grinding. We like to put the spotlight on them.
Spotlight.
So
you front and center.
Yes.
Front and center. I'm right in the middle. I got the spotlight on me. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully,
so before,
I don't.
Before you get into it, because we have a few questions, and then we want to get you to sing us out of here. But we want to know, when you get into your vehicle, when you get into someone else's vehicle, what music are you looking for? What is your artist that you bounce to? What song is doing it for you right now?
Well, I definitely feel like we live in an age where music is at its highest in terms of shareability, following, attention. So with as much attention as music and several artists get nowadays, they're open to a lot of praise and open to a lot of criticism. So with that, I would say there's different music for every situation.
Mm-hmm. So you're more versatile.
Versatile, yeah.
Depends on your mood.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah. But I have like my top five kind of like things I listen to.
Give it to us.
Give me three.
I listen three. Okay. obviously, hip hop is number one. I listen to the J. Cole's, the Drake's. I listen to a lot of underground artists. Simba Lives Long. He's this guy out in New York. He's really, really, really dope.
Wow.
I listen to a local artist. His name is Manny Wells. He is pretty dope.
I haven't heard that.
You know him.
I've heard that name.
Yeah, he toured with Jadena, I think, like a year or 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. He had a big show out here in D.C. last year in March, and just a bunch of stuff he has going on. I listen to a lot of artists who have something to say. That's right. Yeah. Not because, you know, like, everyone has a voice, but not everyone should talk.
Yeah.
So I listen to those who have something to say, because that's good for my soul, you know.
There you go.
Wow.
So you have an old soul.
Yeah, why are you so young?
Off camera, we was listening to what you had to say, so I told her you was our therapist on the cover.
Yeah,
I got relationship advice, you know. I'm young, but I'm wise for my age.
Yeah, definitely. We see that.
Well, tell us a little bit about, I mean, I'm looking at the time, because we want to make sure we give you the full time when you perform your song, but... Right. I just want the viewers and the listeners to know a little bit about, you know, when did you begin? When did you know that you wanted to have this singing career? How did that all start? Again, he is from the DMV areas, but he is in New York now. So how did you end up in New York and now you're singing and making videos and you're just on your way? And tell us about that.
All right. I'm going to make the 22-year-long story.
Okay. Yeah, that one.
conversation. So I remember being about 3-4 years old. I was in the living room of my mother and stepfather at the time apartment, and I think Michael Jackson was performing on television for like an MTV award or something, and I remember being mesmerized by how much passion he had, the effect he had on everyone in the crowd.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember thinking at that little age, I was like, I want to do what that guy's doing.
Yeah.
You know, I see how people are reacting. I see how serious and how into what he is, what he's doing. And I just felt like that's what I needed to do. So ever since then, I've always known I wanted to work in entertainment. I wanted to entertain people. I wanted to be an outlet for people. I wanted to be the voice for the people. I just knew I wanted to do that. And as life has gone on, I played the trumpet in elementary school. I was in the choir.
You get some feedback a little bit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I was in choir. I helped start an acting club in school. I did an internship in Lagos, Nigeria at a television studio.
I'm Nigerian.
Oh, you're Nigerian?
100% Nigerian.
You're my sister now.
Yes. I did find you. Yes. Yeah, 100%.
So, Igbo, Yoruba, Hausa?
My grandmother's Igbo.
Oh,
man. Wow. I lived there for 5 years.
Oh, yeah. I was there for 2. I went to boarding school in Lagos, Maryland.
Okay.
Yeah, wow. My sister is here.
Yes. You see that? Look at that.
Yeah. So, I went to boarding school in Nigeria, and while I was there, Halifield College, the school I went to, they had an internship program for all the freshmen, is what we'd call it here in America, to go on an internship for something that they like. Everyone knew I enjoyed entertainment, so they sent me to a television studio, and I was this very, very popular soap opera called Tinsel in Africa. I was took an internship there, and I met so many dope people, and it was that moment that I knew this is exactly what I need to continue to do.
Wow.
I came back to the States to finish high school and go to college. Throughout high school, all I did was art. I was in choir. I performed at the Kennedy Center. Largo High School, I was part of the year where we created an album that actually hit number one in gospel.
Wow.
Won a Grammy as well. Yay. Which is great. So like it's dope.
Yes.
To say that.
How awesome. Dope is that? Yes. Yes.
thank you. And I got emails from the school called AMDA, the American Musical and Dramatic Academy, and they wanted me there. So I did everything I had to do. I went to school in Manhattan, studied for 2 years, an intensive program with a focus in acting and performance. And I have to say, it is the staple of where I am today. It's definitely set me on the right track of my artistry.
Wow. I'm so proud. I'm really...
You have put a lot of work in.
It's a marathon, not a race.
Yes.
R.I.P.
I'm super proud. And again, like Stan and I, we were watching some of your work on your social media and some of the things that you've done. And we were just like, wow. You know, it's talent. Young talent and just spotting talent. So we want our viewers and listeners to see some of this talent. So we want to make sure that you get to tell everyone how they can follow you, how they can find you. And we're going to close the show with him showing us some of his talents that we have had the privilege of seeing. Right. Yeah.
And never before heard music, too. So.
Yeah. Ooh, exclusive.
I had to bring exclusive spotlight. Spotlight only. Spotlight yes. First time. You know what I mean?
Did you need me some extra vocals on it?
I mean, yes, I actually do. There's a part in the song where...
Oh, okay.
I'm going to say repeat after me and just repeat what I say.
Okay, I got you.
All right.
Okay.
So this is going to be your debut, babe. Don't mess this up. Man.
What?
Protect the brand.
Don't you just love them? I love couples that work together, you know?
So anyway, we'll be right back. Spotlight
right back.
Of the city.
One and only Guy Lambert is in the building.
I put the spotlight on your city. See the superstar.
saying your spotlight over the city is on to something bigger than y'all think.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
See the superstar.
Hollywood to Hollywood. Girl, you look good. Yeah, they hollering, baby.
What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy?
Yes.
Keep clapping so I put a clapping to that boy.
Oh, y'all.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
See the superstar.
Y'all backstage with the one and only Mr. Trey Chain. Give it up.
And when you in the DMV, you rocking with Spotlight Over the City.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.
See the superstar.
Spotlight, spotlight.
Spotlight over the city.
Spotlight, spotlight.
Spotlight over the city.
Welcome to Spotlight Over the City, and I'm here with the one and only, the big homie of all big homies.
All right, you are now listening to Zachary Chambers, Chambers with a Z. We are here at Spotlight, and I am on the spotlight. All right, I got a song I wrote. It's a love song, and it's called Closure. I did it to a cover of a Logic track. He's also from Maryland, so I hope y'all like it. Yeah.
Okay.
Beautiful baby girl.
I said beautiful, beautiful.
Know you are a light in my world.
A light that's in my world. Check.
But girl, I think you should know.
Listen, I hate to think about how long we're gonna last. I know I miss your jokes and I know I miss your laughing. Staring in your eyes, I'ma miss it all the time. You know I would be lying if you weren't on my mind. And you know I would be lying if I said I didn't love you so much to let you go, even if I ain't want to. Love you so much, want you to live your life. You deserve a man's heart, even if it isn't mine. Hoping every moment I am giving you real love, cause we have experienced real love. Not the kind of story you just make up. See these memories you can't run away from. I'm writing this song not because I think it's over, but even if it was, it would be the perfect closure. Never wanna bring tears to your eyes. If you don't know how I feel, I'ma say it one more time.
Beautiful baby girl.
You are beautiful, beautiful.
Know you are a light in my world.
A light that's in my world.
Through the dark that we have to let go.
Girl, I hurt you, but no, girl, I hurt you, and I did not mean to, but girl, I needed to let you know, how I feel, cause what I feel is real for you, and what I see in us is true, so know that. I'm in love with you. Yes, I'm in love with you. Love with you.
Beautiful baby girl.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Know you are a light in my world. Through the dark.
Come on.
That me have.
All right, I'm gonna need some participation with this one. Just gonna repeat after me, all right?
Girl, I think you should
check.
Know.
I said, I know you do a lot.
I know you do your best.
I know you do your best.
So you're better than the rest.
You're better than the rest.
You're better than my ex.
You're better than my ex.
I said I know you do a lot.
I know you do a lot.
And I know you do your best.
I know you do your best.
So you're better than the rest.
You're better than the rest.
You are better than my ex.
You're better than my ex.
I said I know you do a lickety lot. Oh. I know you do your biggity best. Better than the rest, rest.
Better than the rest, rest.
You're better than my ex, ex.
Than
I got this
ex,
set. I know you do a lot, and I know you do your best. So you're better than the rest. You are better than my ex, and I know you do a lot, and I know you do your best. You're better than the rest. You're better than my ex. I said,
beautiful, baby girl.
You said beautiful, beautiful.
So you are a light in my world.
A light that's in my world. Through the dark,
I'ma sing it off real quick.
go. Oh, oh. Y'all about to come in with me.
But girl, I think we gotta should know.
Check. I said, beautiful baby girl, know you are a light in my world. Through the dark hurts that we have to let go.
Check.
But girl, I think you should know.
You said let me grow. You said let me board it home.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful,
beautiful,
girl, like beautiful,
beautiful.
Yo, you beautiful.
Beautiful.
Tell her that she beautiful.
You're beautiful.
Tell them that they're beautiful.
Beautiful.
Tell them that they're beautiful.
Y'all beautiful.
Y'all beautiful.
Y'all beautiful. We appreciate you guys, Spotlight Over the City. Thank you guys. Give it up one time.
Thank you so much, Spotlight. Give it up.
Amen. We appreciate you. We appreciate you, brother. We gotta get out of here. We gotta wrap it up. Make sure you guys Umbrella Therapeutic Services. Thank you for being a sponsor. We love you guys. You're amazing. Wes, shout out to Wes. YouTube, make sure you follow us on YouTube, our channel on YouTube. Facebook, we still owe you over there too. Spotlight over the city on there. IG, Spotlight over the city. We got to get out of here and wrap it up. Thanks for our amazing guests one more time. But thank before you. We go, we always got to let you know, love hard, live good, God first. Spotlight
amen,
over the city.
Amen, amen.
I put the spotlight on your city. I put the spotlight on your city.